Yes, children, today let us see about bond parameters. The first one is bond length. Okay, bond length. What is bond length? It is the distance, equilibrium distance between the centers of the nuclei of the two bonded atoms. These are the two bonded atoms. This is the center of the nucleus of that atom, and you join the centers, that is called as bond length. Now, what are the factors affecting bond length? Number one, size of atoms. Number two, multiplicity of bond, and number three, type of hybridization. Now, size of atoms. Now here you find all these are hydrogen halides, and this is iodine, bromine, chlorine, fluorine. This is the smallest atom, this is the largest atom. So here the bond length between hydrogen and iodine is the longest. Okay, and the distance between hydrogen and fluorine is the smallest. Okay, so factors affecting bond length, size of atoms. Now in terms of bond length, the bond length in HI is the largest and the bond length in HF is the smallest. Now longer the bond, weaker it is and it is easy to break. Okay, so what I said, longer the bond, weaker it is. Okay, so bond dissociation energy will be less. You need to supply less amount of energy to break that. Then multiplicity of bond. Here there are three bonds, two bonds, one bond. Now greater the number of bonds between any two atoms, shorter the bond length. Okay, greater the number of bonds between any two atoms, shorter the bond length and stronger it is. Okay, so this is the strongest. So in terms of bond length, if you consider, where there is a triple bond, the bond length is the shortest. Where there is a single bond, the bond length is the longest. Now, same way, type of hybridization also makes a lot of difference. Okay, so this we will see a little later. Now, then comes bond enthalpy. What is bond enthalpy? It is the amount of energy required to break one mole of bonds of a particular type, so as to separate them into gaseous atoms. This is called bond dissociation enthalpy or bond enthalpy. So bond dissociation enthalpy is generally called as bond enthalpy. Now what are the factors affecting bond enthalpy? Again, size of the atoms. Greater the size, greater the bond length. Lesser the bond strength, lesser the bond enthalpy. This is what I showed you here. Longer the bond, weaker it is, and bond dissociation energy will be less. The same thing here. If the size is greater, then bond length is greater, bond strength is lesser, and bond enthalpy is also lesser. Then multiplicity of bonds. Greater the number of bonds between any two atoms, greater is the bond order. Bond order is nothing but number of bonds between any two atoms, that is called as bond order. Right? Now, greater is the bond order, greater the bond dissociation enthalpy. Okay, so that way you find here it is single bond, double bond, triple bond. This is associated with the highest bond dissociation energy than this, than this. So hydrogen ka sabse least hai aur nitrogen ka sabse highest hai. Now this is one reason that nitrogen is inactive. Why nitrogen is inactive? Because of high bond dissociation enthalpy. If you break this bond, only then the two nitrogen atoms will go for reacting with something, is it not? So if you are not able to break it, then it will remain as N2, right? That is why you say it is a unreactive gas. And that is why you are flushing this nitrogen in the chips packets. Try to recollect your memory what you studied in 10th class. Okay? Then apart from that, number of lone pairs of electrons present. That also is one of the reason. Greater the number of lone pair of electrons, greater the repulsion. Obviously, lone pair of electrons, what I have told you, ये खाली दिमाग वाले bond bond बनाना नहीं होता. It is just staying as it is on an atom. So they will show more and more of repulsion. And if the repulsions are more, then the bond dissociation energy will be lesser. So that's what is given here. See, how many lone pairs are there? 3 lone pairs on each fluorine, this side and that side, right? And the bond dissociation enthalpy, dekho, least. Where there is single bond and there is no lone pair, look at the bond dissociation enthalpy, it is so high. Is that clear? So, greater the number of lone pairs, smaller the bond dissociation enthalpy. So, that is your bond enthalpy factor. Then comes bond angle. Angle between bond pairs of electrons in a molecule is called bond angle. Is that clear? These two are bond pairs. Now, what is the angle between them? That is called as bond angle. Now, this is a lone pair, okay? Now, not this angle, but between two bond pairs. That is what is called as bond angle. Same way here, there are two lone pairs, is it not? So, you are not going to talk about the bond between, I mean, the angle between lone pair and the bond pair. It is always between two bond pairs. So, that is 104.5. In the case of BF3, it is 120, okay? Bond angle decreases in the presence of lone pairs. You see that very clearly. No lone pair, 120. Again, no lone pair, 109.28. One lone pair, 107. Two lone pairs, 104.5. So, bond angle decreases in the presence of lone pair. Now come to the next property, that is bond order. Bond order is nothing but number of bonds present between any two atoms. Okay, in the case of hydrogen, it is 1. In the case of chlorine, it is 1. In the case of oxygen, it is 2. In the case of nitrogen, it is 3. The number of bonds, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, like that. Now, surprisingly, bond order may be fractional also. Okay, say in this case, you have a double bond between the two. And if you are drawing the same thing like this, that is this one electron and along with this pair of electron, it is 3, is it not? So double bond is already there and just take the lone pair of oxygen and the single odd electron of nitrogen put together as 3 electrons. So this 3 electron bond is considered as half covalent bond. Not a single covalent bond, it is considered as half covalent bond. Hence, bond order in the case of NO is 2.5. It was actually 2. If you put these two together, then it is considered as a half bond. So, the bond order is supposed to be 2.5. Okay. And what is the concept behind this bond order? Those which are having same bond order, they would be isoelectronic in nature. And that is, their number of electrons will be same. Say F2 and O2 2 negative. F2 9 plus 9 18. O2 16. 8 plus 8 16 plus 2 electrons. So together there is 18. So these are isoelectronic species and they have the same bond order, that is 1. In the case of nitrogen, carbon monoxide and NO plus, each having 14 electrons, the bond order has been found to be 3. Right? Now, what else you need to know about this? Greater the bond order, greater the stability. Shorter the bond length, stronger the bond. Okay? And greater the bond strength. Greater the bond order, greater the stability, greater the bond strength, shorter the bond length. Right? Bond order is higher means bond length is smaller. So that is why you say triple bond is shorter than double bond is shorter than single bond. Right. Now let's come to the next topic, that is covalent bond. Now you know what is covalent bond. It is formed by the mutual sharing of electrons between any two combining atoms. Now this covalent bond is of two types, polar and non-polar. Polar means between unlike atoms, and non-polar means between like atoms, like in the case of hydrogen, fluorine, nitrogen. These are all like atoms and the bonds are non-polar. You can't say one is more electronegative than the other because they are of the same kind. So here what you find, the electron cloud is symmetrical at the center. There is no charge separation. You can't say this will behave positive, this will behave negative. Okay, so that is characteristic of non-polar covalent bonds. Now in the case of polar covalent bonds, what you see? The shared pair of electron between hydrogen and Cl is more towards chlorine. It will exist like this. Hydrogen ka jo electron hai, wo chlorine ke paas aa gaya. Theek hai? The shared pair of electron is shifted towards the more electronegative atom. And the electron cloud is displaced. When the electron cloud is displaced, that is this pair of electron is shifted towards chlorine. So this will develop a small positive charge and this will develop a small negative charge, delta positive and delta negative. So since there is separation of charges, you call this bond as a polar covalent bond. Polar means two extreme qualities. Okay, and this extent of polarity in a covalent bond is measured by dipole moment. And what is dipole moment? It's a vector quantity. It has magnitude as well as direction. You must have studied about vector and scalar quantity in physics, right? This is a vector quantity. It has magnitude as well as direction. Now, this polarity is showing partial ionic character of covalent bond. Okay? Dipole moment. What is dipole moment? How do you define it? It is a product of charge and the distance between the charges. Okay? Mu is the symbol for denoting dipole moment. That is equal to Q into D, where Q is of the order of 10 power minus 10 ESU, that is electrostatic unit. And this D is the internuclear distance, that is of the order of 10 power minus 8 centimeter. So mu is of the order of 10 power minus 18 ESU centimeter. And this is equal to 1 debye. Right? Now, what is this 1 ESU? 1 ESU is 1.6 into 10 power minus 19 coulomb upon 4.8 into 10 power minus 10, that will give you 3.33 into 10 power minus 10 coulomb. This is 1 ESU. And what is 1 debye? It is to the order of 10 power minus 18 ESU centimeter. And 1 ESU is this many coulomb. Okay? So, 10 power minus 18 ESU would be, if 1 ESU is this many coulomb, then 10 power minus 18 ESU, how much it will be? 10 power minus 18 into 3.3 into 10 power minus 10. This centimeter ko denote karne ke liye 10 power minus 2. When you want to convert it in terms of coulomb meter. This is CM, means coulomb meter. And what is this 1.6 into 10 power minus 19 coulomb? It is the charge of one single electron. It is the charge of one single electron. Okay. So in terms of coulomb, it is 1.6 into 10 power minus 19. In terms of ESU, it is 4.8 into 10 power minus 10. Right? So that is why you are converting this into coulomb. 1 ESU is converted in the form of coulomb.